गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स। थैंक्स टू ऑल फॉर योर विशेस। मेनु माधव 220-00272104712105822 सोमोजीत 210471210758 गौरव अरविंद हरि केशव वेंकट साई शुभम रोहित निकिता उद्धव प्रणव उदांशु कल्याण अवय साई सुदर्शन सरकार अनमोल शेल्डन थैंक्स सलजार। इन यस्टरडे क्लास वी स्टार्टेड प्रेशर मेजरमेंट एंड आई होप वी कवर्ड पीजियोमीटर यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सम क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू दैट वन एंड वी विल लर्न सम स्पेसिफिक कंसेप्ट पार्टी आफ्टर गेट फर्स्ट गेट ए गुड रैंक इन गेट and then contact me, then we will enjoy. First, we will solve some questions to make it clear because students have a lot of confusion in all these questions, if it will go downward, and we will solve 2-3 fundamental questions and then automatically all the concepts clear. Let's start. This chart of PDC and this chart means 2 marks. If you want, you can take a screenshot of this one. In PDC from this chart, every year you will get a 2 marks question in match the column. Temperature. Take a screenshot. 1 chart, 2 marks. Temperature, pressure, then flow meters, liquid level, capacitance probe they asked in gate 2017 or 2018, displacer device they asked in 2016, then composition, thermal conductivity cell they asked already in exam. This is a mother chart. You will get each and every question from the measuring device from this chart only. Every question. Let's start. Please tell me the number of questions that we have solved till now. The number of questions that we have solved till now. 21 questions we have solved. 21, 22. Which one is correct one? 22. Write down question number 23. A manometer is used. A manometer is used to measure the pressure of a gas in a tank The fluid used here has a specific gravity of 0.85 and the manometer height is and the manometer column height is 55 centimeter is 55 centimeter as shown in figure if the local atmospheric pressure is is 96 kilopascal determine the absolute pressure within the tank Solve it. I need answer from each and every student. Its specific gravity is 0.85. Solve it. You have 2 minutes. right answer of this question is, very good, 100.6 kilopascal is the correct answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 students remaining. Is the wrong answer. 141 also wrong answer. Here, if you will do mistake in such type of question, then time up. Now let me solve it. First, density is equal to specific gravity into this one. 0.85 into 1000, 850 kg per meter cube. We know that at the same horizontal line, in the same fluid, the pressure will be same. At this point, the pressure will be, and at this point and this point, the pressure will be same. So we can write P is equal to P atmospheric plus rho g h. So P atmospheric is given in the question, that is 96 kilopascal plus 850 kg per meter cube. Into 9.81, but we need in kilopascal, so we will get this value. So we will get P is equal to this plus this. And you will get 100.6 kilopascal. That is the correct answer of this question. Sir, in diagram you gave 5 centimeter. That is 55 centimeter, not 5 centimeter. Check Sheldon. It is 5 or 55? 55 centimeter. So the right answer is this one. write down next very important point, which will help you to solve all the questions. Consider YouTube manometer. This point is very, very important. Consider YouTube manometer. Or YouTube simple manometer. Consider YouTube simple manometer. Is measuring pressure. Is measuring pressure of a fluid of specific gravity S1. So to write an equation, for pressure of the fluid, flowing, point should be kept in your mind. First point, start from one end of the gauge to another. Second, add the pressure. Add one end and then add the change in pressure. While moving from one level to another. Third point, use positive sign if the next level of contact is lower than first one, lower than first, and use negative sign. Use negative sign if it is higher. And this point is very, very important to solve all these questions. You studied all these things in your 11th class. At that time also you are in doubt, and today also. But today we will, on my birthday special, I will remove your all the doubts from this concept. So use positive sign if you will go in downward, because as you will go in downward direction, pressure will increase. And if you will go in upward direction, the pressure will decrease. The sign is higher. These are the important points related to this one. write down one more point. Jumping horizontal, noting that jumping horizontally from one tube to the next. And realizing that pressure remains same. In the same fluid. Simplifies the analysis. With the help of all these concepts, you are able to solve questions within few steps only. Now we will solve one other question. If you are able to solve this question, then I will consider you are able to solve any question of the exam. Question number 24. A very nice question. Here we have water. This is H1. Suppose water is represented by this color. then it is H1. Then here we have OL. This one is oil, and after that we have mercury. This height is S2. And this height is S3. And here we have mercury. We have three fluids, water, oil, and mercury. Draw this diagram. A very wonderful question. The water in a tank. The water in a tank is pressurized by air. Is pressurized by air. And the pressure is measured by pressure is measured by a multi-fluid manometer. Pressure is measured by a multi-fluid manometer as shown in above figure. The tank is located. The tank is located on a mountain at an altitude of 1400 meters, where the atmospheric pressure is,85.6 kilopascal. Determine the air pressure in tank. If H1 is equal to 0.1 meter, H2 is equal to 0.2 meter, and H3 is equal to 0.35 meter, take the densities of water, oil, and mercury. To be 1000 kg per meter cube, 850 kg per meter cube, and 13600 kg per meter cube, respectively. Solve it. If you are able to solve this question, then I will understand. Then you can solve any question of the grade. This question is a very nice question. Settle down. Just try to solve. Your all the doubts will be removed. Just you need to follow these three, four points. to get right answer. And you have 3 minutes to solve this question. Solve it. सर बर्थडे पे तो आपको गिफ्ट मिलना चाहिए एंड यू आर क्लियरिंग अवर डाउट्स एंड गिविंग अस प्रेजेंट भाई इट इज अवर ड्यूटी सॉल्व इट यू हैव 3 मिनट टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन एंड इट्स माय रिक्वेस्ट टू ईच एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट प्लीज अटेम्प्ट दिस क्वेश्चन Tell me the right answer of this question. Very good, very good, very good. 129 is the correct answer. It means you got that concept. But now 44 kilopascal is the wrong answer. Very good, 129.6. That is nice. It means you got the concept. All the 29, the students who are getting 29. Only 4 students got right answer. Why not others? Sir, show the question. Where were you? This is the question. This diagram. Last 1 minute. Time up. Somo Provo, answer is wrong. 129.6 or 130 is the correct answer. Only 5 students got right answer. But no problem. This question is very wonderful question. And you need to apply the concepts. Now we will go with rules. My first rule is that start from one end of the gauge to another. Now we will start from this point. Assume this point is one. Is it clear? Now we will start from this point. Now second, you need to take care of two things. Write the pressure at one end. Add the pressure change in while moving from one level to another. Use positive sign if we will go in downward direction. Use negative if we will go in upward direction. And from one in horizontal direction, from one tube to the next, but in the same fluid, the pressure will be same. Now we will analyze it. Now tell me equation. Now we will start. I need to delete this one. That we can write below this. At this point, assume pressure P1. At this point, pressure is P1. Is it clear? Now we will go horizontally. From here to here. Now we are going in downward direction because at this point, because then we are going in upward direction or downward direction. This point is below one or above. This point is below or above. This point is below. It means. We need to add. Very good. This point is below. It means we will get positive sign plus rho into g into h1. Yes or no? Or we can say rho of order plus rho of order. E into H1. Then again, from here to again move horizontally. Again, we are coming in downward direction. Again, we will get positive sign plus rho of OL G into H2. Is it clear? Now this time from here to that point, we are going in upward direction or downward direction? We are going in upward direction. In upward direction, in negative sign, rho of mercury, G into H3, and that should be equal to the, here we have atmospheric pressure, so we can write P2 or P atmospheric. If you have any doubt at any point, just ask, because all these concepts are very nice concepts and students have a lot of confusion. This is our final equation of this one. In similar manner, you can write for any question. Upward direction negative, downward direction positive, but remember one thing, in same type of fluid. Is this concept clear to each and every student? Sir, please explain once more, and why, sir, negative? Just try to think. If we are going in upward direction, okay, pressure is going to increase P, you know, in any tank, P is equal to rho gh. As the H is going to increase, the pressure is going to increase or decrease? Sai Sudarshan and 21176. As you will go in P is equal to rho gh, H is going to increase, it means pressure is going to increase. Now, reverse of that. If you are going in upward direction, it means H is going to decrease. If H is going to decrease, then pressure is going to decrease or increase. Then pressure is going to decrease. Is it clear? Somaprova, it means your mathematical mistake. Your math faculty was ma'am, and your total concentration was on ma'am only, not on mathematics. So in such a manner, just in upward direction negative, downward direction positive, and you need to jump in horizontal direction in same fluid so that you are able to write the equation. Now we will put the value. So we will get, we need to calculate the P1. So P1 is equal to E ATM minus rho of water GH1, rho of oil GH2 plus rho of mercury GH3. P1 is equal to 85.6 kilopascal. Let's take G common. Rho of mercury S3. Rho of water H1. Rho of oil S2. So P1 is equal to 85.6 kilopascal plus 9.81 meter per second square, 13,600 kg per meter cube into 0.35 meter minus 1,000 kg per meter cube into 0.1. minus 850 kg per meter cube into 0.2 meter. One equation, one variable, two marks. So the value of P1 is equal to nearly 130 kilopascal. A very nice question. Is it clear? A very wonderful question. Note down. Is it clear? Avoid, but they took nearly gravity nearly constant. Seldon, I hope now you are able to solve all these questions. Just you need to take care of two things: upper direction negative, downward positive. You need to jump horizontally in same fluid. Sir, please give one more such type of question. Okay. Write down next question. Now we will solve directly one gate question, very nice question of gate 2022 marks. Question number 25. One of the best question from the pressure measure devices that they asked in last 30 years. Gate 2020. Again 2 marks. A YouTube manometer. A very nice question. A YouTube manometer. Contains manometric fluid. Contains manometric fluid. Contains two manometric fluids of densities. (1000 kg/m³) and 600 kg/m³. When both the limbs are open to atmosphere, then both the limbs are open to atmosphere, the difference between the two levels is 10 cm at equilibrium. As shown in figure, here P, here Q, and this is 10 centimeter. The rest of the manometer. The rest of the manometer is filled with air of negligible density. The acceleration due to gravity is 9.81 meter per second square, and the atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal. How much absolute pressure within bracket in kilopascal has to be applied on the limb P to raise the fluid in limb Q by another 20 centimeters. First one is option. Second option. Third option. Last option. Very nice question. Solve it. You have 3 minutes to solve this question. The right answer of this question will be one student is getting one, one student is getting two. Then why discrimination with third and fourth? Rohit, check just once again. Last 1.5 minutes. This is one of the best questions they asked in last 30 years from pressure measurement. Very nice question. Very nice. 2200027 21047. Very nice. B is the correct answer. 210758. A is not the correct answer. Very good. 2 is the correct answer. Kuhika Das, your answer is also nice. Very good. 4 students got right answer. But out of 60, if only 4 students will get, then kaise chalega, bhaiya? Last 1 minute. Very good, very good. Keep it up, keep it up. I am feeling happy because you are going to solve such type of questions. Time up. Let's start. Nikita, your answer is also correct. Now just we will go step by step. Now first we will calculate case first as per the given situation. Again we know that at the same level the pressure will be same. A U-tube manometer contains 2 manometric fluid of density 1000 kg per meter cube and 600 kg per meter cube. When both the limbs are open to atmosphere, the difference between the two levels is 210 cm at equilibrium as shown in figure. Now read question up to this point only. Okay. we know that at the same level, at the same level in two limbs, of liquid A, the total pressure is identical. The total pressure is identical, or the total pressure is same. So first, we will discuss at equilibrium. How many of you sold? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only 6 students sold. That is not good. At equilibrium, we will write. At these both the levels, the pressure will be the same. Assume this height is h at equilibrium. And one point is this one, and one point is this one. Because he has same static fluid, so at this point and this point, the pressure should be same. Is it clear? Assume this point is first and this point is second. Can I say from the above diagram, P first should be equal to the P second? Is it clear? Here you have air. It is of 10, it is of H. So at this point, we can write the pressure equation. We will get P of P plus H into, that is centimeter, H into water, that is 1000 kg per meter cube, into G rho GH. That is the required pressure at that point should be equal to the P of Q plus at that point H plus 10, rho is 600 into G, rho GH. Both the points are open to atmosphere. P of P is equal to P of Q, 9.81, 2020. 10 H is equal to, you will get 6 into H plus 10. For H is equal to 16. So H is equal to 15 centimeter in this equilibrium condition. Note down. H is equal to 15 centimeter. So this value is H is equal to 15 centimeter. I hope this first step should be clear to each and every student. Yes or no? Or is it clear that in this case you are getting H is equal to 15 centimeter? Sir, so how P of P is equal to P of Q, because both the points are open to the atmospheric pressure, and if both the points are open to atmosphere, then P atm is equal to P atm. That's why P of P is equal to P of Q hurricanes. Yes or no? Sir, यहाँ तक आंसर आया था. Okay. Something is better than nothing. Hari Keshav, I am asking to you. Both the points are open to atmosphere. Sir, explain H plus 10. Sai Sudarshan, is there any rocket science in H plus 10? You want to calculate pressure at this point. So this total height is H plus 10. So this P at the this pressure plus rho g h, that is H plus 10. That's why I am going to take H plus 10. Sai Sudarshan. Actually, that is the basic problem with us. Our basics are. Hey, Sai Sudarshan, now it is okay. Why? Sir, what? Which one is the datum line? Always we will took this one in the same this one is the datum line. So from year to year H plus 10. Got it? Okay, now we will move towards second step. Now read question. The rest of the fluid is okay. The acceleration due to gravity and the atmospheric pressure is this. How much absolute pressure has to be applied to limb P to raise the fluid in Q by another 20 centimeter? If you will apply pressure at left limb, then the level of the left limb will going to decrease and the level of right limb is going to increase. If the level of the right limb is going to increase by 20 centimeter, it means the level of the left limb is going to decrease by 20 centimeter. Is it clear? Are, if the level of the right limb is going to increase by 20 centimeter, it means level of the left limb is going to decrease by 20 centimeter. Yes or no? Very good. Now we will use this concept. This question is very nice question. At the time of solution, even 90% coachings also gave wrong answer of this question. Now we will discuss the case second. Now case second, you will feel like that. Diagram is like that. Now this level is of 15 centimeter. There is air, no problem. Then when it will go or it will decrease up to 20 centimeter, your next datum line will be 5 centimeter below from that one, because 20 centimeter this one. Now draw diagram according to that. Now your next datum line. Below 5 centimeter from the initial one, and this one is going to increase. This 20 centimeter is going to increase with the same fluid. this additional 20 centimeter, and already they have, it was, we assume it is liquid A and it is liquid B, and already we calculated H plus N, already this is 25 centimeter. This is P and this is Q. I hope this diagram should be clear to each and every student. If you have any doubt at any point, just ask. Because all these are fundamentals, again, they will ask any fundamental question and then you are not able to solve. If you will try to mug up the concept. Is this diagram clear to each and every student? Sir, why 25? Which one is to? Why 25 in Q-lim? That H plus 10. If that H plus 10 is already present, that H we calculated 15 centimeter and that 10 is given. So 10 plus 15 is equal to 25 centimeter. Just remember, it is already 10. But this is already present. But when this is already present in this H plus 10, it means 15 plus 10, 25. But now we are going to add liquid of A or fluid A, 20 centimeter. So it, this value will not change now. This will remain 25 centimeter and we will add more of fluid A in the range of 20 centimeter because that is going to increase the level by another 20 centimeter. Is it clear? Very good. Yes, sir, each and everything is crystal clear. Thank you. Now we will apply equation. Okay. Now write the equation. Now your question is that how much absolute pressure is needed? How much absolute pressure is needed must be applied on the limb P to increase this value by 20 centimeter. So liquid A drops by 20 centimeter in this one. Now write equation. Assume it is at this point P of P prime. And assume here it is Q, P of Q. Then P of Q plus due to pressure due to this liquid B and due to this liquid A. So 25 into 600. Into 9.81, but we need answer in kilopascal. So we need divide by 1000. There is one thing which I actually that level was up to this point was 20 centimeter. And from this one, this will be 25 centimeter. If you will compare with the initial one. And this one is 25 centimeter. Plus again 25 into Density is 1009.81 in terms of kilopascal. 1/1000. So after solving, you will get 100 kilopascal plus solve it 25 into 9.81 divided by 60, or you can take common also. That is in centimeter, then you need to calculate in meter also. Then only you will get right answer in this one. 100 into 1000 plus 600. So P of P prime is equal to 100 kilopascal. And after solving this value, you will get 3.924 kilopascal. So the right answer is 103.924 kilopascal. That is the required pressure that we need to apply on left limb P to increase level in limb Q for next 20 centimeters. If you have any doubt at any step, just ask without any hesitation. Because if you will feel hesitate here, then you will feel hesitate to solve question in exam. Okay, I am going to explain once more. To remove your confusion, I am going to draw all these three diagrams at one place. That's why it is not easy to get a good rank. You need to brush up your concepts. This is the initial condition. This is the initial condition given. And it was in 10, it was given 10 centimeters. And with the help of calculation, we solved it 15 centimeters. So this total was 25 centimeters. It is P, it is Q, here atmospheric pressure P of P, and here atmospheric pressure P of Q. And we assume that liquid A, and this one is liquid B. Is it clear? First diagram. Is first diagram clear? Very good. Now second one. After that, we are going to decrease it. We are going to decrease the level by 20 centimeters. Then our next, it is 15 centimeter. If you are going to decrease 20 centimeter, then you will get next diagram. Like that only, it is our initial one. If you are going to take or compare with that one, then if you are going to decrease by 20 centimeter, then you will get the next level of the this one. Up to this point, yes or no? So it is 15 centimeter plus 5 centimeter, 20 centimeter. Then in next diagram, this liquid A will be like that. Now what is the scenario? This is now 5 centimeter because it is decreased by 20 centimeter. If it is decreased by 20 centimeter, it means initially the level is at that point. Now you will include that increase from here 20 centimeter. So this is the increase, right? As per question. And this is already 25 centimeter. Yes or no? Are yes or no? Again, it is of P, it is of Q. Now, you need to manage all these things. Now, we will write equation as compared to at this one. Then you will write. Assume at this point the pressure is P of P prime. Is it clear? Now this height is already 20 cent. This height is 25 centimeter. This height is 20 plus this is 5. So this height should be also 25 centimeters. And the atmospheric pressure is going to apply, that is P of Q. And at this point, you need to calculate the absolute pressure, that is P of P prime. So that should be equal to P of P prime should be equal to, because again, we will move in horizontal direction. The pressure at this point should be same because we have same fluid. Then we will get PQ plus pressure due to fluid, pressure due to fluid A, plus pressure due to fluid B. So pressure due to this one, rho GH2 plus rho GH1 plus this one. So in this case, in this manner, you will get the right answer. I hope now it should be crystal clear to each and every student. Yes or no? Now, in which manner, sir, why did you write 25 centimeter? Very good. Now, is it clear to each and Akshat? Now, is it clear? Now it should be crystal clear to each and every student. I am asking once more, if there is any doubt, just ask. Because at that time, 11th class also, you did not ask. That's why today you are confused. Is it clear to each and every student? This question was very nice question. Very good. So if you are able to, and last, both the last questions are conceptually, highly conceptually question. That known gate and this one is from gate. Now let's start next one. Very nice. Write down next. Write down A, that is single column manometer. Write down next, that is third one. Single column manometer. Stand alone. I hope now your all the doubts should be removed. Today now you will sleep properly after understanding all these concepts. Actually, what was the limitation of YouTube manometer? The limitation of YouTube manometer was that method requires that method requires reading of fluid level at two or more points. At two or more points, since a change in pressure. A change in pressure causes a rise of liquid. In one limb, of the manometer. And a drop in the other. And a drop in the other. So this limitation of YouTube manometer is removed in a single column manometer. Or we can say it is a modified form of YouTube manometer. It is a modified form of YouTube manometer in which a shallow reservoir having a large cross sectional area about 100 times as compared to the area of the tube is introduced into one limb of the manometer. into one limb of the manometer. For any change in pressure, for any change in pressure, for any change in pressure, the change in liquid level, the change in liquid level in the reservoir will be so small, that it may be neglected, that it may be neglected and the pressure is indicated, and the pressure is indicated approximately by the height of the liquid in the other limb. Here you need only, you require only one reading. Only one reading. In the narrow limb, of the manometer need to be taken for pressure measurement. For pressure measurement. Now here we have two types. Single column manometers. Vertical single column manometer and inclined single column manometer. Write down first one, vertical single column manometer. Vertical single column manometer This one is known as reservoir. Assume from this point to this one is H1. And this is delta H. Assume it is the original river. And this height is S2. Draw this diagram. Now apply. We can write A into delta H is equal to A into H2. So value of delta H is equal to A into H2 by capital A. Where A is the cross sectional area of the reservoir small a is the cross sectional area of the right limb cross sectional area of the right limb cross sectional area of the right limb H2 is size of heavy liquid in right limb And this H1 is height of the center of pipe height of the center of pipe height of the center of pipe above level so that was the simple mathematics And you can write pressure at this point also. P is equal to rho g h2, and here also rho into g into h1 plus delta h. That is the simple mathematics. So if we have pressure P A, which is to be measured, P A plus rho 1 into g h1 plus delta h is equal to rho 2 into g into delta h plus s2. So you will get P A is equal to rho 2 g delta h plus s2 minus rho 1 g delta h plus h1. So value of PA is equal to delta h rho 2 g minus rho 1 g plus h2 rho 2 g minus h1 rho 1 g. And one more thing, as the we know that the as the area capital A is very large as compared to A, hence ratio A by A becomes very small. Becomes very small and can be neglected. So we can write PA is equal to H2 rho 2G minus H1 rho 1G. When we will solve question, then automatically the remaining doubts will be clear. What is PA? PA is the pressure at A. Assume this point A, pressure at A, which is to be measured. Which is to be measured. Rho 1 is density of liquid in pipe. And rho 2 is density of the liquid in reservoir. Finally, this part is also finished. Simple manometers finished. And we will study three things, or we have already finished three things and two remaining. Piezometer we finished. YouTube manometer finished, and single column manometer finished. Sir, please show the screen once. Here why we are going to take datum line at this. I hope you noted down. Yes, 220027. At the all have the same principle that the pressure at the same horizontal level are same. Sir, under rank 100, do people get call from IIT? Or if you have even under 500 also, then you will get call from IIT. 211176, that's why na H2 plus that small delta H. Sir, will you be teaching the same subject next year's wells? I mean FM and thermo only. In a specific coaching site, took specific subjects only. Okay, now sir, it is crystal clear. So why it is not crystal? We made it after a struggle of 2 hours. I hope now you are able to solve such type of question. Sir, many happy returns of the thank you. Sir, how much to score get a decent rank? You need to get 70 marks to get 70 rank. Very simple formula in chemical engineering. Get 70 marks and under 100 rank. And it is one of the easiest task which you can do. Okay, bye, take care. Have a nice day. Now we will end tomorrow. We will finish the pressure part. And then we will start next topic. I hope up to this point, each and every basic and fundamental should be cleared. Because every year from up to this point, you will get at least 2 to 3 marks in GATE exam. Circle cake leke aana hai. Arre, this time no one will cut the cake. Every year, I used to teach in classroom. So every year we cut cake in classroom. But this time we are in virtual classroom. So that's why it is difficult. And birthday is a simple day. Even I don't celebrate all these things also. Sometimes when I get time. Just like. Sir, everything is clear. Okay, thank you.